Hello guys, this is my first video in English, so please be kind and understanding. There is one thing that has been bothering me for a while and it needs some clarification. There was a scientific debate on the Veritasium channel on YouTube about a faster than wind vehicle. Millions of viewers watch it, however, I'm afraid that Derek's conclusions are wrong. Of course, the main conclusion is correct, but his arguments are wrong.
So, this car works like a lever or a pulley. By applying a small force to the wheels over a larger distance, the propeller can apply a larger force over a smaller distance. This is just like when you're riding a bike going uphill. You move the pedals fast, but with smaller force, to make the wheels move slower over the ground, but with a bigger force.
The mechanism does not behave that way because of the leverage. So let's find out the truth. We have our vehicle at the beginning of the experiment. It's standing motionless in relation to the ground, but moving in relation to the air masses. Let's assume for the moment that the vehicle is not in contact with the ground, and let's consider what kind of forces act on him, ignoring gravity. In this case, there is only one force, the aerodynamic drag, which acts on its entire structure, and more precisely, on its surface perpendicular to this force. So what's going to happen in such environment? Of course, this force is going to move and accelerate the vehicle in relation to the ground. At the same time, it's going to slow down the vehicle in relation to the air masses. Ultimately, this force will disappear when the vehicle stops against the air. That is the target state that this system will try to achieve in such a scenario. Before adding the ground to this example, let's think what would happen if we add the tangential force that drives the wheel. The wheel would spin and propel the propeller. If the force is applied tangentially, the maximum torque value will occur. So the whole force will be used to make the wheel rotate. According to Newton's second law of rotation, it will not move the vehicle in relation to the air, but thanks to the rotation, it will drive the propeller and generate thrust and move the vehicle in relation to the air masses. It doesn't matter where we apply the initial force, whether upwards, downwards, or to the right, if it's tangentially, it will make the wheel rotate without moving the entire vehicle in relation to the air masses. It is like engine in a very basic plane. Ultimately, in such a system, the vehicle will start to accelerate in relation to the air masses thanks to this force. If this is clear, we will now go back to our original layout. We have our vehicle at the beginning of the experiment, standing motionless in relation to the ground, but moving in relation to the air masses. What forces are acting on the vehicle now? Of course, aerodynamic drag force, which decreases with lower speed, but there is also the rolling resistance between its wheels and the ground. It is constant force, and it only changes and grows at really high speeds. So when the aerodynamic drag force is bigger than rolling resistance force, the vehicle starts to accelerate in relation to the ground, but slow down in relation to the air, according to Newton's second law of motion. Due to this ground movement, force turns the wheels, and this force is transferred to drive the propeller. This force is tangentially, so it only sets the wheels in spin, but does not slow down the vehicle. As the speed in relation to the air decreases, the force of the aerodynamic drag decreases. But as the speed in relation to the ground increases, the speed of the rotating wheels increases. And thus, the rotating propeller begins to generate more and more thrust. The vehicle accelerates in relation to the ground all the time, because the driving forces are bigger than braking forces. From the ground perspective, of course, because until the wind speed is reached, the vehicle brakes against the wind. An important note here, although the vehicle itself has not yet reached the wind speed, the propeller is very likely to generate thrust because it is spinning fast enough. At some point, when our vehicle reaches the wind speed and stops in air masses, the force of aerodynamic drag braking it against the air will disappear. But due to the fact that the propeller has already generated the thrust exceeding the force of the rolling resistance, and according to Newton's second law of motion, nothing spectacular at this point will happen. It will continue to accelerate. It's propelled by the ground moving under the wheels, and as the speed increases, the speed of rotation of the wheels increases, which increases the speed of the rotation of the propeller, and you may think that it will propel itself endlessly. However, this will not happen, because the force that originally moved the vehicle in relation to the ground will now start working the other way. The aerodynamic drag of the vehicle, after exceeding the momentary state, when the vehicle is stationary in relation to the air masses, will now start to break it in the other direction, and as the vehicle speed increases in relation to the air, this force will increase faster and faster, until at some point the forces will balance and the vehicle stops accelerating. This will be the target state for this system as long as the ground velocity in relation to the air does not change, because that is the only energy acting on this system. Let me know, guys, what you think about this explanation. I hope this is the final explanation of this puzzle, intuitive and simple as it should be from the beginning, because it is not a rocket science. It is a pity that my film will probably not be noticed at all, but I hope that the few of you who watch it will agree with me that we got to the truth. If there are people here who speak English and would like to stay longer, let me know. Greetings to all of you. Hey.